Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today we are going to show you how to calculate the number of days, months, and years between two different dates in Microsoft Excel. So by the end of this video, you should be able to take two dates that we have here in A2 and B2 and calculate either the number of years between those dates, the number of months between those dates, or the number of days between those dates. Also, we will have some additional training options for you at the end of this video, so stick around for that. So for our first example, let's do the number of years between the dates that we have right here in A2 and B2. So to do that, I'm going to click in C2 and type equals date diff with a left parenthesis. And the first argument, even though it's not showing up here, is what date do I want to start with? So I'm going to click on A2 and then type a comma. The second argument going in here is going to be the date where I wish to end. So that's in B2, and I'm going to click on that. And then I'm going to type a comma. And this last argument, I'm going to type double quote, a Y, and another double quote for year. Because in this case, I want the difference between two dates coming out in how many years there are between those two dates. So I'm going to close my parentheses and hit enter. If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell button to get notified when we release our weekly videos. And I can see that I'm being returned with a 2 because between 2024 and 2026, there are 2 years. Now this is going to round down for the number of years. So if I go back to B2 and I put in 9/1 of 26, and hit enter, I can see that Excel is calculating 1 year in between 2024 and 2026. And that is because the 9/1 has not reached a complete year yet from the starting date of 9/12. So Excel is going to round down to the nearest whole number of years in this case. So for our second example with month, we are going to use the same equation, but we're just going to change the last argument. So I'm going to type equals date diff with a left parenthesis. And my first argument is my start date, type a comma, click my end date, type a comma. And in double quotes this time, I'm going to put a 1M, close my parentheses, and hit enter. And I can now see that there's 26 months between these two dates. And that is true. But again, if I go back here and I do 11/1/26, I can now see that that month has not been completed yet to the 12th like it is over here on 9/12, so I am going to get 25 instead. And for our last example, with the number of days, I'm going to type equals date diff again with a left parenthesis, click on my start date, type a comma, click on my end date, type a comma, and this time in double quotes, I'm going to put a D, close my parentheses, and hit enter. And now I am calculating the number of days in between these two dates. Now we go into this a little bit more in detail out on our blog, and I'm going to include a link to that blog entry in the description below on YouTube if you would like to go there and learn more. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them for us and we'll get back to you. Thanks for watching and see you again next time. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.